From the question of dark matter to interstellar cigars, here are 10 recent space discoveries. Number 10. We came out of a bubble. Up until late last year, scientists had a popular theory about how our solar system came to be. They thought our galaxy had been created near a supernova, which is an exploded star, using a combination of two isotopes called aluminum-26 and iron-60. What are isotopes? Well, put as simply as possible, it's when a chemical element takes different forms but shares certain properties, while at the same time being different. Got it? Okay, let's keep going. By studying ancient meteorites, it was observed the aluminum isotope was there at the start of the solar system in large quantities, but less so for the iron. That means a slight problem for the old theory, as supernovas throw out both isotopes. It calls the whole cosmic dealio into question. So experts started looking around for other aluminum-heavy possibilities, which is when they considered something called a Wolf-Rayet star. A Wolf-Rayet star is a supermassive star up to 50 times bigger than the Sun. It's so incredibly hot that it spews its own surface out into space, carried by strong winds. As the material flies away, the wind essentially becomes part of the Wolf-Rayet star's surface, and a bubble is formed. Theoretically, dust and gas are trapped inside the bubble, creating the right conditions for stars to be born. The name used for these bubbles is stellar nurseries. Aww, doesn't the thought of all those little baby stars make you feel all warm and fuzzy inside? Very warm, in fact. Go anywhere near that thing and you'd melt in an instant. Number 9. Synestias. How do planets get made? The prevailing wisdom is that they're formed from things colliding in space and the resulting wreckage turns into a planet. That idea got a bit of a tweak last year when researchers suggested something called a synestia. What's a synestia? You may be surprised to hear it's a donut. Yep, a giant spinning donut in deep space. The name comes from combining syn, meaning together in Greek, and Hestia, who was the goddess of structures. A synestia is a structure that's created when really big objects the size of planets bash together. These objects also have the same angular momentum, which basically means they're both spinning. This combination of a huge collision and both objects spinning results in an epic donut made out of extremely hot rock. The momentum that comes from the two spinners smashing together gives it the ability to go into orbit, which technically could mean this is how planets are created. In fact, similarities between the Earth and Moon has led scientists to think the two spheres were once part of a big synestia. So the implications of this donut-shaped theory are pretty huge. Number 8. Does dark matter exist? All things are made of matter. If you want to know what matter is, then you're probably sitting on it. A chair is solid and has a definite mass, as is the floor it's resting on, as is the computer, phone, or tablet you're using to watch this video. Basically, if it takes up space in the universe, it is made of matter. There are different forms of matter, including dark matter. Dark matter is thought to make up 80% of all the universe's mass. Pretty important. However, like with anything cosmological, there's a certain amount of guesswork involved, and there's still so much we don't know. Dark matter theory has become an accepted way of explaining universal mass and all that emptiness in space, but recently people have started questioning how reliable a theory this is. Parts of the idea are pure speculation and could be replaced at any time the more we discover about the universe. So is there dark matter or not? And now for number 7. But first, if you are new here, welcome, and be sure to subscribe before you leave. We have lots of new videos coming up. Number 7. Exomoons. Last summer, there was great excitement at the discovery of something in space believed to be an exomoon. An exomoon is a moon which orbits a planet in another solar system. The find came via NASA's Kepler telescope and gave people hope that their theory about exomoons was correct. The reason they're so exciting, apart from the fact that it's an alien moon, which, let's face it, is pretty cool already, is that moons in our solar system have proved capable of supporting life. So if we spot a moon in another system, it's one step closer to possibly showing life exists outside our galaxy. Thrilling stuff, huh? It doesn't mean to say the object is definitely an exomoon. Closer analysis has led experts to state it's unlikely to be that due to the data not being very good because the object is so far away. So-called exomoon hunters, how would you like that for a job, have said the evidence is by no means conclusive. In fact, there are so many theories of how to spot an exomoon, it becomes a confusing process, and the object could be anything, even some kind of satellite. Watch this space for more details. Get it? Watch this space? Never mind, I'm just kidding. Number 6. Kilonova. Last August, a spectacular event happened when two neutron stars spiraled into one another in deep space. A neutron star is what remains when a star explodes. It's made up of powerful neutrons and dense matter. When neutron stars crash, it's like a major fireworks display in space. This light show is called a kilonova. Burning blue, then red, the effect is caused by glowing debris from the neutron star collision. A kilonova burns much brighter than a plain old regular nova. Gravitational waves, X-rays, and radio waves were also released, making this a true one-off for astronomers. Over 70 observatories joined forces to study the kilonova, and they found out some pretty neat stuff. For example, it was confirmed for them that gamma ray bursts were caused by colliding neutron stars. Also, it's believed elements like silver, gold, and platinum come from these types of events. Keep your eyes open because gold could be raining down from the sky at any moment. Number 5. Super-Earth. I mentioned an exomoon before, and this is an exoplanet. An exoplanet is a planet found outside our solar system orbiting a star. And this one right here, 39 light years away in the constellation of Cetus, is a doozy. It's been named LHS-11406, which isn't very catchy, so another name for it is Super-Earth. Much better, right? Experts called it that because, like our planet, it's capable of supporting life due to its rocky terrain made up of irons and silicates. Also, the exoplanet is positioned in a so-called habitable zone, which means that water could be down there. Super-Earth is 5 billion years old, 11,000 miles in diameter, and is 40% bigger than regular Earth. It orbits a red dwarf star, which is a small, relatively cool star. NASA won't know a lot about it until they get their powerful James Webb telescope up and running, and that won't happen until 2020, so I'll keep you posted. One major thing that was confirmed by the discovery is the existence of rocky planets over 1.5 times bigger than Earth. Before this, it was assumed bigger planets were made of gas. I'm of course not sure what it would be like visiting a planet made of gas, but one thing's for sure, leave the matches at home. Number 4. Jupiter's spot. The vast orange and red spot on the surface of Jupiter has intrigued astronomers for centuries. It's actually a huge storm they've been observing since the 1870s, though mention of it goes back to the 1600s. That storm has been going on for a long time. The spot is made up of long bands of wind blowing at 400 miles per hour. What it does is eat little storms in a kind of medieval banquet of weather systems. These smaller storms go around the planet and are consumed by Jupiter's spot before being sort of regurgitated and go around the surface again. Epic, but a little strange. Since 1920, a decrease in the spot's size has been noticed. You can currently fit the Earth in there, but before there was room for 3 whole Earths. The reasons for it getting smaller aren't known, but apparently the spot is deepening in color and the storm is also getting taller as it shrinks, so it's like a column of wind. We are now witnessing Jupiter's shrinking spot. Number 3. Moon water. Okay, so you may have heard this thing about how the moon is made of cheese. Well, we hate to disappoint you Wallace and Gromit fans, but the truth is it's pretty rocky. There's water there too, though we only found this out a decade ago. In 2010, it was thought a small ocean was beneath the surface, contrary to what was previously assumed. As with all these things, speculation plays a major part. We got a step closer to working out how much water is on the moon last year by studying satellite data of pyroclastic flows. Don't know what a pyroclastic flow is? Where have you been? Just kidding. It sounds complicated, but it's kind of cool. Pyroclastic flows relate to volcanic activity. Yes, in case you didn't know, the moon has volcanoes. Not only that, but when they erupt, they spew out these little glass beads made of crystallized magma, and inside those beads is a small amount of water. That means there is definitely a lot of water under the surface of the moon. In the 70s, Apollos 15 and 17 took samples of the beads and brought them back for study. Back then, they had no way of telling if this was a widespread phenomenon, but now satellites have revealed the presence of water beads from volcanoes across the moon. Water, water everywhere! Number 2. Brown dwarf. In 2016, a planet-sized object was spotted 22,000 light-years away. The huge scale of it became a talking point among astronomers because by their calculations, it was 13 times the size of Jupiter. So that's pretty big. It was named OGLE 2016 BLG 1190. Guys, come on, you've got to start giving these things proper names. No one has actually seen the planet-type object, they just know that it's there. How do they know? That's due to the light from its parent star becoming brighter, meaning its light was being focused by gravity coming off the new object. When they see this, it's called a gravitational microlensing event. That's all well and good, but what is this thing? A working theory is it's a brown dwarf, which is kind of a star that's not quite a planet and not quite a star. Make up your mind, brown dwarf. What's really interesting is that it was found somewhere called the Brown Dwarf Desert, where none have been seen before. Whatever it has an orbit of 3 whole years, so experts will have to wait a little while longer for another shot at analyzing the dwarf. Analyzing the dwarf, another cool thing astronomers do on a daily basis. Number 1. Oumuamua. Finally, a cool name. This extraordinary cigar-shaped object was seen late last year and is the first ever interstellar object seen in our system. It was spotted in Hawaii, so it was named Oumuamua, meaning a messenger from afar arriving first. It's thought to be an asteroid and was traveling at an eye-watering 196,000 miles per hour. It was shooting through the stars on course for God knows where, having apparently been dislodged from its position in space by the gravitational forces of huge gas planets. These forces are so powerful it's believed that is how Oumuamua got its long shape. Yes, despite being made of rock, it got stretched like silly putty. Asteroids or comets are referred to as planetesimals, and Oumuamua fits into that category, though it also throws up more questions than answers. It appears dry and doesn't shed any gas or dust, so people are assuming it's an asteroid. Doesn't mean it is one, of course. Not like you can ask it to slow down so you can check, right? Thanks for watching! Are there any cool space discoveries you've heard of that you'd like to tell us about? If so, leave a message in the comments. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye!